Let's go.
Team Warlock, baby. Team Warlock. Oh, dude, I got the catalyst to drop for the air.
What?
I just turned in the metal and it gave me the exotic catalyst.
What?
Yeah, bro.
What?
No way.
Dude, yeah, yeah, bro. He just gave it to me. Did you guys get it too?
No.
You guys totally got it, right? You guys totally got it?
Oh, what a good shit.
Fallout?
The Heir Apparent Exotic Catalyst is finally up for grabs in Destiny 2, now on the table with the 2021 Guardian Games event. You want to get that Exotic Catalyst, and I want to help you get it, so let's dive right in. First of all, if you don't already have the Heir Apparent Exotic Machine Gun, don't worry, you can get it right now and it shouldn't take you any time at all. Head on over to Big Daddy Z at the tower, then talk to Grandma Levante at the podium to kickstart the Guardian Game event thingy. Levante will first give you a quick quest that requires you to collect 100 laurels. Go hop into the Guardian Game playlist to make that happen. Shouldn't take you long at all. When you're done with that, head back to Mama Levante at the tower, pick up your contender card, and then you can pick up the exotic quest for the Heir Apparent if you don't have the gun already. Don't worry, the quest is stupid short. There's really only two things you gotta do. Part one, collect 50 laurels, which you can do again immediately in the Guardian Game playlist. And then part two, get 100 machine gun kills in the Guardian Game playlist, easy. Quick side note, by the way, wow. Do you have any idea what we went through to get that exotic machine gun last year? Like, do you have any idea? And now you can just go to Levante and get it for, you know what? It's fine. Okay, now you've got your exotic machine gun. How do you get the exotic catalyst? You've got to do a little Guardian Game grinding. Keep playing the Guardian Game event, make sure you're collecting laurels, and then eventually head back to the tower to make sure you can earn medals. When you've gotten to the point where you can come back to the tower and start dunking medals into the podium to support your team, that is how you get the exotic catalyst. Every time you dunk a medal, you are pretty much pulling the lever on a big ol' slot machine. Every medal put into the podium is a chance at the game randomly rewarding you with the Heir Apparent Exotic Catalyst. For me, I think I got it after dunking my first gold medal, but both of my buddies didn't get their catalyst to drop until they dunked their first platinum medal. We're kind of assuming that the more valuable the medal you dunk into the podium, the better your shot at getting the catalyst to drop. Can't really confirm that, but you probably won't have to dunk too many medals before getting the catalyst. Anywho, now that you've got the quest for the exotic catalyst, you've gotta bang it out. Step number one, you gotta collect enough medals to earn 50 points. I'ma repeat that. You don't need 50 medals, you need 50 points. Each medal that you earn has a point value for the exotic quest. For example, when I earned a platinum medal, that was 10 points right there. So if you want, you can do 5 platinum medals for 10 points each. Naturally, the higher the medal, the higher the point value, so try to go big. Here's a really good way to help part one of the exotic catalyst go a little bit quicker. Remember that if you go into your Triumphs menu into Season of the Chosen, then the event portion, Triumphs that you redeem related to the Guardian Games can actually give you medals. So wait until you're on that part of the quest, then head over to the Triumph section and start turning those in. Don't do it before. If you're worried, by the way, that the platinum medals will be really hard to earn, yeah, they aren't. The Nightfall Platinum Contender card was dummy easy. All you need to do is kill a lot of enemies, and FYI, you don't even have to do the hardest Nightfall difficulty. We literally went in on the lowest Nightfall difficulty, allowed extra enemies to keep spawning in during the boss fight, and we got our platinum medal in one Nightfall run each time. All right, when you've done 5 platinum medals, or just a bunch of medals to hit that 50 point value, now you're on part two, complete 3 contender cards. Kind of annoying, considering you're probably gonna do a few contender cards before getting to this part of the quest, but yeah, now you gotta do 3 more. Now, when I was doing this, me and the boys heard a rumor in our Twitch chat where platinum contender cards wouldn't count towards this part of the exotic quest. To be fair, I probably should have looked into that rumor a little bit more, but I didn't want to potentially waste anybody's time. After speaking to some other people, I've now heard that that rumor is total bullshit. Even though the other contender cards, i.e. the Strike, PvP, and Gambit cards, are cheaper to buy, I will 100% recommend continuing to roll with the Platinum Contender card. Again, the Platinum Nightfall Contender card, shockingly easy. I ended up doing 3 Strike Contender cards, and even though they were 100 laurels cheaper to pick up, The completion requirements made me want to slam my balls in a car door, get solar or void melee final blows or finishers while in a strike, and yeah, that means a charged melee kill, by the way. The Platinum Nightfall card was so much easier. I should have kept doing it. Good news though, you can learn from my mistake. Keep rolling with the team and do the Platinum Nightfall Contender card all the way. All right, now you're almost at the end. You gotta go into the Guardian Game Strike playlist and get a bunch of machine gun kills to generate competitive spirit, whatever the hell that is. I went into the playlist, found the nearest Lost Sector, and just went in. Won't take you long, believe me. After that, your Exotic Catalyst quest should be finished, meaning all you gotta do now is usually what you always have to do. Open up the exotic gun and manually equip the Exotic Catalyst. All you gotta do now is kill 700 enemies with your machine gun. I know, sounds like a lot, but remember there are easy ways to get that done. For example, you could go into Last Wish and do the Shirochi wall code to get teleported to the Shirochi encounter and repeatedly kill Thrall. I started off doing it in the Altar of Sorrow, which was pretty easy. Eventually though, I managed to get a checkpoint for the Shadow Thrall portion of the Shattered Throne dungeon, aka the Thrallway. That was really easy, but you gotta get the checkpoint, which is annoying. I say if you have a friend with the checkpoint already, go do the Thrallway. If you don't have a checkpoint or a friend with the checkpoint, go roll into the Altar of Sorrow on the moon. And that's it, bam, 700 kills, and now your exotic catalyst for the heir apparent is Dunzo. If you're wondering what it does, two things. One, it makes the arc shield on your exotic machine gun a tad beefier. We figured it gives your shield about 80 health in PvP, give or take a few. Thing number two, if your arc shield gets broken while using the gun, you'll auto-reload a portion of your ammo directly into the mag. Now, I'ma be real with you. I don't know if I'm actually gonna use the gun in either PvP or PvE. It's still kind of a meme weapon to me. If I'm playing PvP and I want a really good exotic to kill people, I'm probably gonna use the Wardcliff Coil. If I'm playing PvE and I want a really good solar weapon, I'm probably gonna use the Xenophage. I don't know, never say never, but maybe someday somebody will find a cracked use for the heir apparent. You never know. Oh, and by the way, if you are one of those crazy people who actually wants to try and make the heir apparent work in either PvP or PvE, God love ya, remember that incoming arc damage is not your friend. Check it out right here. When I'm in a private lobby with my buddy and he shoots my heir apparent arc shield with either a kinetic weapon or any non-arc weapon, yeah, my shield breaks when I take too much damage, but no big deal, right? Now look at what happens when he breaks my shield with an arc weapon. I think here he used the Waking Vigil hand cannon. Bam, break my shield with arc, and wow, I am very, very hurt. Kind of a major reason why I feel the heir apparent still needs work. A lot of PvE enemies use arc damage, you know. It's a tad less common in PvP these days, yeah, but still. But anyway, there you go, how to get the heir apparent exotic and the exotic catalyst. Do me a favor and click the like button if you found the info shared today helpful, and click that big red subscribe button for more content in the future. If you haven't done so already, do me a favor and head on over to my Twitch channel and make sure you give me a follow there so you can come hang out when I stream live. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.